In the previous video, we will discuss about the different types of mechanisms, so along with the degrees of freedom and different types of we have been discussed about the inversion of mechanism and four bar chain mechanism. So in this video, we are going to discuss about the different types of inversion mechanism. So we have been discussed about the inversion mechanism. So inversion mechanism is nothing but by fixing the different links in a kinematic chain, can able to obtain the different types of mechanisms can able to be obtained in the kinematic chain, that is what we called as an inversion of mechanisms. So now we're going to see about the some of the different types of inversion mechanisms along with the diagram, how the can able to convert the motion from one form to the other for to do any mechanism. So first type of inversion of mechanism what we can able to see is crank rocker mechanism or beam engine mechanism. So mainly this type of mechanisms are used to convert from one form of motion to another form in order to perform the or to complete the given task in any machines. See, in the machines, all the parts will be interlinked. So in order, all the parts will be having a relative motion with each other. Hence, the relative motion can be easily obtained by fixing the different types of links. We can able to get any different types of mechanisms. So here, how we can able to convert from one form of motion to the other form in order to perform or to complete the given task in the in any machining process or in the machine. So here first we are going to see about the crank rocker mechanism or a beam engine mechanism. So where you can able to see this crank, where about the fixed link A is the crank and the link 3 is nothing but, see here the link 1 frame is what we call the fixed link, normally we call it as a frame, that is a link 1, and the link 2 is nothing but we have a crank as a link 2 where it has been connected to the point A to B, and the link 3 it is connected to point B to C. And the C is nothing but it will be having connected to the lever, that is the link 4, which is called as a lever. So in that lever, in the another side of that mechanism, it has been connected with the piston, and the piston is connected to the cylinder. So this is about on a crank and beam mechanism. When this at point A, when the crank starts rotating about its axis, when you can able to see from this point, when it starts rotating about its axis, what happens? Normally the link 2 is been connected to the link 3. So the link 3 starts moving towards. So what happens, this link 3 starts oscillating. Here what happens, because the link 3 has been connected to the link 4 in the help of the lever. So what happens here, the oscillation movement is taking place. So oscillation movement taking place is nothing but the piston rod moves inside the cylinder, where the reciprocating movement is taking place. Here from the rotary it has been converted to the reciprocating motion, where the piston and cylinder is moving here. Similarly, if we consider from the mechanism from the this end, whenever this starts reciprocating, here it has been converted from reciprocating to the rotary motion. So the link 2, when it starts rotating about its axis, the link 3 has been connected to the lever. So where it is starts, the lever starts oscillating, then this piston and cylinder starts about the reciprocating. So this is how we can able to convert the from one form of motion to the other form. So in this crank rocker mechanism or a beam engine mechanism, so we can able to consider, or we can able to convert from reciprocating to the rotary, or from rotary to the reciprocation motion can be easily converted here. We can able to see the crank rotates about the fixed center A, the lever oscillates about the fixed center D, where you can able to see at the point D, the end E is a lever. So CD is connected to a piston rod which reciprocate due to the rotation of this crank. So this is how about a beam engine, or we call it as a crank rocker. This is one of the inversion of four bar chain. So next one is about we called as a drag link. So here the link 2 is fixed. So link 2 will be fixed, and the both the links 1 and the link 4, both the link 1 and link 4 can make a complete rotation about their axis. So both the link 1 and link 4 can able to completely can able to make the rotation about the axis, but with a different velocities. Even the both the link 1 and link 4 can able to make a complete rotation, but it cannot able to make any complete rotation, but it can able to make a complete rotation with the different velocities. Here the link 2 will be fixed, and the link 3 will be acting as a connecting between the link 1 and a link 4. So this is how we can able to consider as a drag link mechanism. So next one is about another type of mechanism, what we call as a double crank mechanism. Mainly this type of mechanism is used in the steering system, or what we call as in the four wheeler vehicles. So in this mechanism, you can able to see the number of links 1, 2, 3, 4. So the link 4 will be fixed, and the link 2 can able to make its rotation. With link 2 can able to make the complete rotation, where the link 3 and the link 4 can able to oscillate. So here the rotary motion can able to be converted to the oscillating motion can able to be takes place. So that gives the direction to the wheels. So this is how it has been connected between the two wheels. So this can how it can able to gives the direction towards the wheel when the link 3 and 4 starts oscillating and the link 4 is fixed. Link 2 can able to make a complete rotations where the link 3 and 4, you can able to see this link 3 and can able to 4, 4 can able to oscillates whenever it is making a one complete rotation. This is how we can able to consider a double, this is what we call it as a double crank mechanism. Yes, sir. So next one we're going to see about the another type of mechanism, what we call it as a slider crank mechanism, or what we call it as a slider crank mechanism. So this is a kinematic chain bearing in a four links. So it will be having a one sliding pair and a three turning pairs. So in this kinematic chain or in this slider crank chain mechanism, there will be four links. So one link will be, or one moment will be takes place in the sliding, and the remaining three will be in the turning pairs. So the three turning pairs will be nothing but it can able to move in three directions. Link 2 as in a rotary motion, and this is what we call it as in a crank. So link 3 has got combined rotary and reciprocating. So either it can able to convert from reciprocating to the rotary or from rotary to the reciprocating. So that is what it can able to combine the both the motions. So that is what we call it as in a connecting rod. And the link 4 as in a reciprocating motion, that is what we call it as in a slider. And the link 1, here it is what is the fixed. This mechanism used to convert from rotary to the reciprocating or reciprocating to the rotary mechanism. So now we'll see. So this is about in a single slider crank chain. So where the link 1 is fixed, or what we call it, the fixed link always we'll consider as in a frame. And the link 4 as in a, so link 2 is nothing but in a crank where it can able to rotate. You can able to see this link 2 can able to rotate. So whenever it is rotating, here the reciprocating motion will be takes place in the link 4. So mainly this type of motions is used in the shaping machines, where in order to make the grooves or in order to make the slots. So this type of shaping machining process will be done. So now the link 3 is the connecting rod is are acting between the, or it is connecting between the both the crank and then link 4. So the link 4 is nothing but a slider, and the link 2 is nothing but a crank. So in between these two, it has been connected between these two links, that is what we call it as a connecting rod. So this connecting rod can able to convert from reciprocating motion to the rotary motion, or from the rotary to the reciprocating, both vice versa. So whenever this starts, crank starts rotating about its axis, automatically this rotational motion can able to convert this crank starts, or this slider starts moving, that is it starts moving in the reciprocating motion. So similarly, when this reciprocating motion starts moving, automatically it can able to convert from reciprocating to the rotary motion, or from the rotary to the reciprocating motion it can able to be convert. So the main thing in this is one link will be fixed, always the one link will be fixed, the fixed link what we call it as in a frame. Here the link one what we have been used, the link one is fixed, and the link two is nothing but mainly what we call it as in a crank, and the link four is slider. So to connect between the crank and the slider, where it can able to convert the motion, we required one more link to connect between that two. The two is nothing but crank and a slider. To connect between the crank and a slider, we required one more link or one more support. So that support what we called as an, or we have been connected with the connecting rod. That support what we called as a connecting rod. So with the help of this connecting rod, now we have a relative motion between the link two and link four. Now which are the reciprocating motion is taking, so it has been connected to the link 4. So it starts moving in the reciprocating. This is which rotates in a rotary motion. It starts moving in the reciprocating motion. When it starts moving in the reciprocating motion, so there is link 2, that is the crank, can able to convert that reciprocating to the rotary motion. So here rotary to the reciprocating, or from reciprocating the rotary. So this easily we can able to convert the mechanism from reciprocating to the rotary and from rotary to the reciprocating motion. So these are the some of the types of inversions of mechanisms. As we know that inversion of mechanisms is a group of kinematic chains, where if you're going to fix the different links in a kinematic chain, we can able to get any different types of mechanism. So far that is the some of the examples of obtaining a different mechanisms by fixing the different links. Thank you.